The voidness of your intellect is Buddhahood. The voidness of your intellect is Buddhahood. What does that really mean? We think. We think we are this body. We believe it. I think I am this. Is there another possibility? There is another possibility. Many mystics and sages have spoken to this possibility. You know, the mind, the human mind, it thinks it's so clever. And yet, there is a space beyond the mind that if you have never felt that, you don't know that the mind, what it truly is. You know, the mind can connect you to everything, or it can separate you from everything. Most of us, that's what it does. It separates us from everything. It puts us into this package. It gives us a way of thinking that's unique, perhaps proudly so. It gives rise to sharp and powerful intellects. But unless you've experienced, even for a moment, a state beyond the mind, it's difficult to understand a phrase like the voidness of your intellect is Buddhahood. There's a clarity beyond the mind that can shine through the mind. How do we get to that clarity? How do we attain it or achieve it? We've perhaps heard of it. Perhaps we disbelieve it. Perhaps we think it's an idealistic possibility toted by charlatans down the ages. You know, to get whatever, to get money or followers or recognition, or, you know. It's unlikely. The voidness of your intellect is Buddhahood. There's a light within the mind, behind the mind. You have to contemplate that. You have to see through your own mind, your own thinking. You have to see how it tries to separate you, how your thinking and your paradigm can separate you and disconnect you from all things. You have to learn to think innocently again, to open your mind to all possibilities, so that you don't hold any single opinion. You can hold that opinion, but you might hold it so lightly because you can see the validity of all opinions. And therefore you can allow anyone to be anyone. But you can still be opinionless in some way. But you can still have an opinion. Because someone who's completely opinionless, you can't often have a conversation with them. So having an opinion and a viewpoint is also a part of being human. But behind all of that, that game, lies something magical. The light of consciousness. The light of consciousness. You know, which is immortal, eternal. You see, the mind, the logical mind, cannot grasp infinity, eternity. It cannot do it. It absolutely cannot do it. You know, it can maybe sort of wrap it up in some kind of circular thinking and paradox. Infinity is a paradox. And infinity is a truth. How can it not be? How can it not be truth? Because it is forever. What was before the beginning? What was before the Big Bang? You know, you cannot penetrate that mystery with the mind. You can only go through with your full being. And that requires a different kind of discipline from thinking. It requires, you know, meditation, prayer, some of these different disciplines that allow you to access that higher plane, let's call it wider plane, that goes beyond the mind. And then you may glimpse a spark of that consciousness that lies behind the mind, beyond the mind, the ecstasy that can pour through your being when you see with eyes like that. So consider that there may be, you know, layers and planes beyond the mind. Open your mind to that possibility and contemplate that possibility over and over, so that you don't get closed into the worldviews of others, into closed worldviews that keep you isolated, into mental paradigms that shut you down from others. Keep an open mind, and then one day you'll understand what that means, that phrase. The voidness of your intellect is Buddhahood. And Buddhahood is to be fully self-realized, and to realize that the mind then is everything. There's nowhere where the mind is not. There is nowhere where the mind stops. The mind is infinity. But the infinite mind is very different from the thinking mind. Things to contemplate.